Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot, and we are back playing Jurassic Park Operation Genesis, the greatest game ever made. I'm just gonna pause for a second to, It makes me so happy. It makes me so bloody happy. Season 2, Operation Genesis, it has been modded. The game looks a lot nicer now than it did last time we played it. And there should hopefully be quite a few new dinosaurs and stuff as well. As well as having all the dig sites unlocked, well, down the line. Ladies and gentlemen, let's play Jurassic Park Operation Genesis. I spent all day trying to set this up. All day. But we're finally there. InGen,
the company that you now work for. Your job is quite simple, really. Build a park, create dinosaurs, and entertain people. Of course, we'll be keeping an eye on you as well.
That looks
we'll
nice.
We'll watch your park.
Back. I love how it says park. Anyway, this is it. I'll show you around quickly. As you can see, the sky is far nicer than it was. Everything's a little bit brighter. This is actually running with an EMB like we've done in Skyrim, but it's quite a sort of a low-key one. It's not a very intense EMB. And it looks awesome as far as I'm concerned. The grass is sort of new and very shiny. It's all cool stuff. I've also got a mod on called the Film Canon mod, which should, it's not a canon of films, although that would be awesome, it should make some dinosaurs or the dinosaurs that were in the films look like they did in the film, which is equally awesome. But more importantly than all of that, ladies and gentlemen, we are back playing Jurassic Park Operation Genesis, the best game ever made, and I am excited. I can't stop smiling. I really can't. And there's birdies, hello. Anyways, let's get a move on, shall we? Check my messages. Build an enclosure and a hatchery. Yep, we know all this. Assign fossils. Let's do this. So, I did install a mod that was meant to give me extra fossil sites, but that doesn't seem to want to work, so we're going to ignore that. But we do have 3 teams available at start, and there are 9 sites unlockable, so we will unlock all of the sites eventually, which means we should be able to get every single dinosaur in the game, which is cool. Let's buy a couple of teams. Oh, right, okay. Lovely jubbly. Check our messages, do some research now. We're going to go ahead and get our medium security fence first, just in case. And now let's get a move. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm really excited. Lovely jubbly. Now, I kind of want, I need an idea. I need it to be somewhat original, like a nice shape, a nice design. I quite like my symmetry and all this kind of jazz. I've got to really decide how we're going to get this park started. Let's have a look. We're going to start with a low security fence, obviously. Now, if you were going to Jurassic Park, imagine you're going to Jurassic Park. Imagine it's the best day of your life and you're going to Jurassic Park. I know this is what you're dreaming about. It's what I dream about pretty much every night. You'd want to see the dinosaurs quite quickly, wouldn't you? Wouldn't want to walk in and have to deal with shops and amenities and all this stuff. You'd want dinosaurs in your face, pretty much. So, I think from there, we're going to nice line across there, like so. And then down there, and across there, and down there. Now, bearing in mind this is only for a small herbivore, that should be enough space for now. Just so there's a nice little dinosaur at the start of the park, basically. And let's go ahead and environment, give him some water. Can't have him dying of dehydration. Lovely jubbly. And a hatchery at the back. And a couple of attractions, I think. When I remember. Yeah, there they are. A couple of viewing vents in there. Always best to get these in before you start putting your paths down. And then we put the path in. Oh, it's been such a long time. This is Jurassic Park Operation Genesis Season 1, as it shall now be called, is by far the most popular Let's Play I've ever done. People go mad for that game. They really do. And you can see what, you know, well, it's the best game ever made. Why wouldn't you go mad for it, eh? But I've missed it. I really have. It's been far too long, ladies and gentlemen. I'm really happy we're back playing this game. A few of you will realise that I was going to do this as a live stream. That was the initial idea. But it wasn't feasible. I just do not have the time at this point in time. Anyways, let's find out what dinosaurs we've been given at the start. We have a Pachycephalosaurus and a Shantungosaurus, which those of you who are very perceptive will realize is a brand new dinosaur. And the Pachycephalosaurus has been supposedly made to look like it's from the film. So we're going to get a couple of them up.
Ladies and gentlemen,
one of my mods is making them spawn really quickly. I'm not really sure which one it is. Not a big deal. Pachycephalosaurus. I think. How much are these fences costing me? I think we might just expand this out again. Because if we're going to add a Shinunganunganunganungasaurus, which I will learn the name of shortly, I don't really want it to be stuck in a tiny, tiny fence. I feel a bit mean, personally. Let's go look at our Pachycephalosauruses. They're butting heads already. Getting to know each other. Hi, guys. Bark. We've got dinosaurs. We've got a thing. Let's go ahead and open up the park.
Certainly.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to declare the newest wonder of the modern world, Jurassic Park.
Now, I'm so excited. Look at it. Look at it. We've got dinosaurs. It's been so long since we had dinosaurs. Okay, let's get a slightly bigger lake over here. Nice little sort of lake area over here. That's nice. I want it to look natural. This is less corporate and more like dinosaurs would live, you know? Okay, what's going on? New fossils, don't care about that. Oh yeah, I can buy teams now. I'm going to buy a couple of teams. Get them on to work, so on that one and that one. Ah, yes, we do need a ranger station. Oh, Edmontosaurus remains. Seems okay. Like we're gonna have quite a like a herbivore heavy start, but that's not a bad thing, is it necessarily? Not at all.
How can I help? No problem.
We're gonna get a couple more Pachycephalosauruses just to pad it out a bit, and then we'll get one of those Shinunganunganungasauruses. I don't know how many new dinosaurs there are, but there are definitely, we've got one already. Security, ranger station, let's get that up. Over, I want it kind of out of the way. People want to feel safe, kind of, but the thing is that what really matters? Do any of us go to Jurassic Park to feel safe? No, we go to an extent, I think people would go to feel, like, the fear, really. Oh, I don't care, I'm just so happy. Do 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 do. And there we go, lovely jubbly start. Now, as with all Operation Genesis playthroughs, there's going to be a lot of waiting around.
Urgent message from Dr. Wu.
Hi. Hello. You're lovely. Trying around like it's nothing, and you doing the same. Yeah, you're all fabulous people. Fabulous, fabulous. What's up, Dr. Wu? What's hanging? Oh, cool beans. Okay.
Your thoughts on this.
Oh, that's not fantastic. 6%? Rubbish. Can I afford... So what I usually do, like I said, we get the medium fence, and then... we get that, but I can't afford that yet. So we need to find something nice and cheap. So let's get umbrellas.
Okay.
People love umbrellas. People love umbrellas. Do you like getting wet? No, you don't like... Okay, some people like getting wet. This is going in a very odd direction. I don't really want to take the conversation this way. Either way, this is quite nice. I'm going to put a little bit... I'm going to get some trees, I think. No, not modern trees. Nobody wants modern trees. This is bloody Jurassic Park. Not for that price. Not for that price.
What are your instructions?
Ooh, okay. Yep. Get both of those on the go. At the moment, we're just going to chill around and let our Pachycephalosauruses enjoy themselves. How's everyone doing? You all enjoying the park?
Good to see you.
Bloody
again.
Weather. Happy. How much do we need for our next critter? Shantungosaurus. I don't really know much about it, I'm not going to lie. Never actually heard of it before now. But... Looks cool. Kind of looks like an Edmontosaurus in model. A lot of them will be retextured models, but they're new dinosaurs at the end of the day. We have 4 dinosaurs and 4 people. That's not a fantastic ratio. So we view through our viewing vent.
Certainly.
Hello. Do 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 do. That's a oh god. Okay. Very sorry, Mr. Hiya. Do 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 do. What's up, Woo? Oh, cool. This is nice. One more visit from the lovely people, and we should be able to get ourselves a brand new dinosaur. Now, just as I was saying, Oh god, okay. Oh, there's a new Humble Bundle. Lovely. Jurassic Park Operation Genesis, at the start of the game particularly, there is a lot of waiting around. You know, at this point in time right now, there's very much, pretty much, nothing I can do. You know? It's just not. That will change, and you guys who've played this before, you know the drill. Ah, but it doesn't matter, look at it. It's beautiful, the sun is shining, the music's terrifying for some reason, that's blinding over there, but that's fine. A couple of nice hills, just to liven up the world, and got ourselves four little pachycephalosauruses. The head-butting dinosaur. Ooh, amber. Awesome. What else we got? We've got medium. Oh, we've got two ambers. Okay. Oh, cool. For those who don't know, I'm going to do a little explaining. Amber, basically, you don't know what dinosaur it comes from. It's worth a lot. High in value. You don't know what dinosaur it comes from, but
what should we do here?
Whichever dinosaur it does come from, it gives a large percentage of genetic-ness to that dinosaur, basically. And the higher your genetic percentage on each dinosaur, the longer lifespan that dinosaur has. So if we go on our pachycephalosaurus down here, get some info up. Lifespan is 3 years, but in a fully 100% genetic one, as opposed to 74, would be something like 8 years or 6 years or 7 years, around there, depending on the dinosaur. So it is always worth it, just maxing them out, because long term it probably saves you a bit of money. Hey. That's nice, nice little joins together. I like this central river as well, it's cool. Oh, hello! Did Jesus come from the sea? Hi! Oh, music, music, music. Best bit of music in the world.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Pachycephalosaurus nearly maxed out. I assume that was an amber hit. So, I'll show you. If we go on to Pachycephalosaurus now, lifespan's 12 years instead, as opposed to free. So just a good 20% or so of genetic validity, as we're going to call it, then it makes all the difference in the world, it really does. I can't remember when I started this video. Huh. Hello, Pachycephalosaurus. Look at them all grouping together. Little Pachy hunters, I guess. Pack hunters is what I was trying to say.
Message from Dr.
Green. Oh, yeah? Look at this little eye. It's kind of terrifying. Let's go on. Edmontosaurus remains. And, ooh. Is that Pachycephalosaurus? Yeah. Hopefully this amber isn't Pachycephalosaurus, otherwise it's kind of a waste. But I don't think it is. We're going to go ahead and sell that, because we've got a medium coming in, which will max it out anyway. And we're going to extract for the Edmontosaurus. Oh, Triceratops! Triceratops! And it should, assuming I've modded this correctly, when I get Triceratops, I don't know why we're so herbivore heavy, but we are. Triceratops should look like the one from the film, from the first film.
Great to see you again.
Where Alan Grant is leaning on it, and it's like going up and down with the breathing, and goes, "It's always my favourite kid, and now that I've seen her, she's the most beautiful thing I ever saw."
Ladies and gentlemen, don't get left out in the rain. Official Boop. Jurassic Park Gale Force umbrellas.
New dinosaur.
Are now available. Ladies and gentlemen, we are pleased to announce the arrival of our latest attraction.
I just want to give them something cheap. Yeah, it is the Edmontosaurus sort of model, which obviously is the same kind of genus as Shantungosaurus. Awesome texture though, isn't it? Look at that. There we go, a Shantungosaurus looking lovely jubbly, very happy, kind of just chilling. Awesomely textured. Very, very cool. Super cool. Okay.
What would you recommend in this situation?
Lovely, let's go have a look. What our max is. 28 years. Now, one of the mods I've downloaded actually makes these. Usually it's not that high, usually it's quite a bit lower. But as far as I know, oh god, one of the mods I downloaded makes the dinosaurs live for the actual lifespan they would have lived for. So a typical Pachycephalosaurus seemingly would have had a 28 year lifespan. Don't know if that's actually accurate, but they look cool. Look at them. This little bony cat thing. I don't know if many of you have seen it. That's a far better texture than the original game, shall we say. I'm quite excited to see what the game can look like at sunset as well. Shantungosaurus remains. Lovely. What else we got? Triceratops, Edmontosaurus, Shantunga. We've got three lovely ones that we needed. Cool beans. Edmontosaurus will be nearly done. Triceratops will be nearly done. What's up, woo? Cool. But at the moment, I'm kind of tempted. I mean, we just keep getting herbivores, so what I might do is extend this out and have this beautiful... No, I don't really want to do that. I was going to have, like, this big herbivore paddock to open the park, but I like to have that at the end. What I'll do is, as the park expands over down this end, we'll have a huge paddock filled with just all the dinosaurs, and you put your, like, your cars in there, and everyone goes driving around, and it's proper Jurassic Park, and it's awesome. It's awesome sauce. Okay, so what we'll do instead is... Let me think. Hello, Shantungo. I should call you Shannon. Hi, Shannon. I don't know if you're male or female, actually. Let's have a look. Not allowed to find out, seemingly. Summary. Nope. Orders. No. Info.
Message from Dr.
No. Never mind. Yay! Oh, they're so happy. Everyone's very happy.
You might like some input here.
Shannon is now 69%. You guys need to calm down. It's only Shintangosaurus. It's not the most exciting dinosaur in the world. Although it is kind of beautiful. Aren't you, Shannon? Shanny. Good old Shanny. Right. Well then, this is nice. I'm trying to think where we're going to put... We've got Triceratops and Montosaurus coming in. I don't really want to cram all my herbivores into one paddock straight at the start. I'm fine doing it later, but I like to have groups of paddocks and it lets the park expand and stuff. How are we doing? Well done! Your addition of another dinosaur species... Wait. Well done! Your addition of another dinosaur species will definitely increase your park's popularity. You say that, but I don't even have a half star yet. Bit rough, innit? Shantungosaurus remains. Lovely. And... Edmontosaurus as well. We should, I believe, between two mediums, be able to make an Edmontosaurus. And we'll nearly get a Triceratops as well. So next time, what we'll do is, we'll build a medium. We're going to need a medium fence, I think, because if Triceratops goes a bit mad... Actually, we can check this. How do we get my Dinosaurpedia? Dinopedia, there it is. So what we need to look at is... Large herbivores. We need the Triceratops. Triceratops. More. Yeah, security requirements, medium. So we'll build a medium fence and we'll put Edmontosaurus and Triceratops in there and we'll add another Shantungosaurus in here just so it's a little bit more exciting for people. We also need a cleaner station, but really, cleaners versus dinosaurs, dinosaurs definitely win. Unfortunately for the cleaners. So let's start building that fence,
urgent
I guess.
Message from John Hammond.
It's a bit pricey, but if we put it, say, there... so pricey. I think we're going to go medium at first and worry about that later. I could do some money. Ooh, half star. Yay. Yay! Can I do another dig site now? Oh, I can. No, wait, no, I can't. I'm excited. Nope. Never mind. Boop.
What should we do here?
Manosaurus might not actually make it, rather annoyingly. Actually, now we've got...
Welcome.
Should be able to up that just a tiny bit. We've gone up half a star. I think half a star is warranting 20 quid. 220 quid? $220 to see one dinosaur is an absolute bargain that I would happily pay, no matter what dinosaur it was. I really like the texture for this one. It looks really cool. Don't you? Don't you, Shannon? You're adorable babes. Arrgh. Oh, oh. We've got a headbutt match going on. Boom.
Aww.
Don't injure each other. I know you're just kind of trying to display dominance and stuff, but there's no point hurting each other in the process. Hurrah! Do not care about the fight whatsoever. Stop making me spend money. Might as well get one of the fat seeds, one of the cheap ones. Let's have a look what we got. Opals, which you just sell for money. Sometimes you get ones that you just sell for gold, which is opals and gold and silver. And they have different qualities and stuff. What are we doing? We've got two Shantungosauruses.
Good choice.
We should be nearly maxed out with those, I think. Okay, let's go ahead and build a cleaner station. I know it's not the most exciting thing in the world, but it is a necessary thing, unfortunately. So we'll put that there, and then let's get a path up. BP? Yep. British Petroleum, always here to save the day. Or ruin it, as the case is usually. And we'll just hire one clean up now while our park's a little teeny tiny. I have to keep turning around and checking the time on my phone because it's so easy to get yourself lost in this game. You can just lose hours just because it makes you so happy. If you haven't got the game, I recommend you do whatever the hell you can to get a hold of it. It does go for ridiculous prices on the PC. Absolutely brutal prices. I actually own two copies of it. I've got it for the PC and I've got it for the original Xbox. And you can find copies online, but it's very hard to get hold of. The thing is, the original developers of this game no longer get any money from it. You know, the people who made this game don't, as far as I know, they don't even exist anymore. It's Blue something Studios. If you have to, guys, I'd recommend torrenting it if you have to. It's just, I feel this is the kind of game everyone should play. And if everyone gets hold of it somehow, considering the game's been out for 10 years now anyway, then maybe we can sort of start to pressure people somewhat into a Jurassic Park Operation Genesis 2. This game deserves a sequel. They could add all the new, imagine this game in current definition, like high definition, current gen software. It could look fantastic. I think we should start, I think, ladies and gentlemen, we should start a, not a survey, that doesn't make any sense. A thing. You know, one of those things. Oh, can I cancel that? No, damn. Oh, we'll just extract it. A poll kind of thing. No, what's the word I'm looking for? Everyone gets your signature. Don't know why, I can't remember what it's called. One of those things, we get lots of signatures. We'll get tons of signatures, and we'll send it off to Universal Studios and a billion game developers. Maybe like an indie developer, maybe we'll talk to the people who made New Zoo Tycoon, that kind of thing, and get them to work on Jurassic Park Operation Genesis 2, because I think there's a real, real call for this game. I mean, it's still got an active modding community. 10 years after the game came out, it's still got a really active modding community, and that says everything about the popularity of this game. People love it. It is my favourite game of all time, and I think that stands for a lot of people, and I think we deserve a sequel. Yeah. Okay. While I'm done ranting with that, let's go ahead. I'm going to set up a low security fence for now. We're going to put this
message from Dr. Wu
here. Along there. Down there. Now, I'm putting fairly big dinosaurs in here, but that'll do, I think. Yeah, I mean that would, yeah, that's a nice size, that's a happy size. And let's go ahead and put a little bit of, what, can I change the size of this?
Message,
oh, I can't.
From
cool.
Dr. Grand.
Oh, don't like that though. It's too formal. I'm looking for, I want the park to be a bit rustic, you know? Okay, so we're going to put another hatchery there, and this is where our, that's probably too much land actually. That's where our Triceratops and a Monta. Oh, that's awful looking.
Message from Dr. Grant.
Okay, we do that. Then we get the water back out. And we put a bit of a dent in it, just so it looks a little less square, basically. What's up, Grant?
Here?
92%.
Message from Dr. Wu.
Lovely jubbly, lovely jubbly. Ooh, silver. Delightful. Got a bit of cash on the go.
What should we do here?
Okay, what can we... I am tempted just to kind of push it over the edge. It's a lot of money. It's a bit too much money. Let's finish setting the base up first. So we need a hatchery. Bum, 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 bum. Bum. No, okay, I'm going to have to put land there. Hatcheries are a necessary evil. They're okay looking. I mean, this one kind of just blends into the trees, but I'd rather have them at the back and kind of out of the way, really. No. Okay, and we need a couple of attractions in here as well. Nice viewing vents. So there and there, and can't afford that. But we'll have another viewing vent there, and then we'll have Admontosaurus and Triceratops running about in this one. Let's go take a look at our Pachycephalosaurus, shall we?
Urgent. Hello. Message from Dr. Wu.
Oh, never mind. Busy things afoot. I've got no money, Wu. I've got no money, mate. I can't keep researching things. Arrgh. Arrgh. Arrgh, arrgh, arrgh. Lovely jubbly, and let's go see Shannon. How you doing, Shannon? That's a low security fence, you're not called Shannon. I'm not going to stop naming the fences, that'd be a little odd. Shannon has angry eyes, but I think she's kind of beautiful. This nice, like, three-tone colour thing. Ah, stunner. Absolutely stunner is our Shannon. How many people are we pulling in? 4, 5, 6. So what we do is, 6 people at 220. We make it to 40. See how many you get. So you push it to the limit and without dropping a person, basically. Oh.
What are your instructions?
Okay, this isn't going fantastically well right now. Let's zoom in. Let's see if... I assume they're all a little bit sort of dead. Poor average. So we take that off that and put that on that. That's good. So actually, we might just take that off that and put that on that. The more you have, the quicker it goes, basically. And if it's a poor one, there's more chance of nothing coming in, which is obviously a pain in the booty. Let's get that final attraction we need for this setup over here. Boop. And then BP set up. BP set up a path. I will not be causing oil travesties or anything like that, I promise. Okay, it's a beautiful day, the sun is shining, our pachycephalosaurus is a dead happy, swimming around, having a ball.
Urgent message from John Hammond.
Okay. Hooray! Ooh! Ooh! New dig site, ladies and gentlemen, new dig site!
Welcome.
Just going to do this little test first. I'm going to make that 260. But it's in progress, so what we'll see is they'll come. Bloody Nora. What's up, Grant? Ooh, Amber.
What are your instructions?
I think we're just going to sell him. Amber's worth a lot, and it's a bit risky because if it's Pachycephalosaurus Amber, it goes to waste. If it's Shunga Shungasaurus, it also kind of goes to waste. If it's the other two, it doesn't. But I think it's worth to keep the money and then go ahead and buy a fossil instead. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it stayed the same, so we can then up the price, basically. Cool. Got a bit of money. And we've got a bit of money. We've got 2 dinosaur species, 2 more on the way, and we've just unlocked our second dig site. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Jurassic Park Operation Genesis Season 2. Modded to look beautiful, modded to have extra dinosaurs. And we're going to keep going, and we're going to make another beautiful 5-star park, and hopefully have every single dinosaur in the game in it. Thank you very much for joining me, as always. Please do like, comment, subscribe, and nice to see you lovely people in there. I'm so excited, I just want to get back and play it. We'll be back on tomorrow, maybe later tonight, if I get my essay done, basically. Until then, cheers, much love as always, bye-bye.